There is a place that is spoken about only in whispers. A dark area that spawns the beginnings of urban legends. A place where anything can happen and usually does. During the light of day, it hides just outside of view. But when the sun goes down, spirits, creatures of the night, roam free, and things do go bump in the night. It is in every state and every country, and there is no escaping it, no matter how safe you feel behind your locked doors and latched windows. So we invite you to turn down the lights and turn up your radio while we join Dave Schrader and Tim Dennis, your hosts, on a journey into the darkness on the edge of town.
Well, good evening, everybody. Good night. We're done. Good evening, everybody, and thank you very much for joining us here in the darkness on the edge of town. I'm your host, Dave Schrader, along with me, as always, my co-host, Tim Dennis, and our new assistant and intern, Ashley. Intern Ashley has a wacky paranormal news story for us, Tim. One of our favorite paranormal shows has gone and jumped the shark this coming season. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Go ahead, hit us with this, Ashley.
Okay, so the former stars of the 1980s action series, The A-Team, reunite for a reality TV program in which they will attempt to contact their deceased co-star George Peppard.
Aww.
Actors Dirk Benedict, Mr. Teen, and Dwight Schultz will appear on a special edition of British paranormal show Most Haunted later this year when they will try to communicate with their old friend who passed away from pneumonia in 1994. Presenter Yvette Fielding says, "We're all going to Los Angeles for a week to film it. It took a lot of doing to get those three together. Now we have to go do the really hard part." Peppard portrayed Colonel John Hannibal Smith in the popular 1980s American TV show.
I pity the fool that can't find Hannibal.
That's right. How sad is that? Most Haunted has jumped the shark. They're putting together 80s sitcoms. Maybe they could put together the team from Different Strokes, Tim, and we can see what happened to their careers. We can try to find the ghost of their careers, you think?
what you talking about, Dave?
Exactly. Kind of sad. We do have one other quick announcement to make before we get into tonight's show. The 2007 South Coast Paranormal Convention is taking place July 20th through the 21st, 2007. The Real Deal presents the 2007 South Coast Paranormal Convention on July 20th through the 21st. At the very haunted Glen Tavern Inn in Santa Paula, California. The speakers are Unknown Magazine founder, psychic sensitive, and TV personality Chris Fleming will be speaking on the paranormal. Ghost Doctor Richard Sennett will be speaking on house memories and retrocognition. Capers founder Derek Bartlett will be speaking on the dangers of dealing with the paranormal. Capers member and psychic sensitive Tom Durant will be speaking on shadow people. PRI member Guy Jackson will be speaking on paranormal sound phenomena. Empathetic, sensitive Chad J. Saunders will be speaking on enhancing your psychic abilities. And can you believe this? They actually have me down as a special guest. Dave Schrader from Darkness Radio. That's right. I'm going to be out there as well. So make sure you come on out. Have a little fun for the weekend. It's going to be a lot of fun. The admission, all the information will be on the website. We're going to have links for it up on our site by tomorrow. And you'll have a $10 off downloadable coupon available online. Raffles will be taking place. There's goodie bags for the first 200 people that sign up, and the featured events include an all-night paranormal investigation of the Glen Tavern Inn, an all-access investigation of the very haunted Glen Tavern Inn, rumored the most haunted structure in Ventura County. So there's going to be a lot of fun. There's a walking tour of the Glen Tavern Inn. There's an intro to tarot workshop. Seance will take place in room 104. Screening of Conjure, which is a movie, will be there with renowned illustrator Matt Bush. Just a lot of fun stuff. We're going to have all that information up and links to it off of our website. So hopefully you'll come out and join us in July, on July 20th and 21st out in California at the Santa Paula, California, at the very haunted Glen Tavern Inn. Now we're going to get fired up into this evening's show. And I got to tell you, this is an interesting topic and one that's been discussed by Tim and I now for the last couple of weeks off air. I actually introduced Tim to the movie The Secret last week. We watched it prior to the show, and our intern Ashley is also familiar with this. It was funny because we all came into this around virtually within a week or two of each other of seeing this. And for those of you that are not familiar, The Secret is a book, but there's also a DVD out there that takes together some of the masters of the field of The Secret and put them together to share their wealth of knowledge on how you can change your life by tapping into this universal consciousness, this universal energy, which sounds you know, it almost sounds far-fetched and hokey until you actually start to look at things and apply it. I had the opportunity to go see our guest this, that we're having this evening, David Schirmer, was in town here with the Learning Annex at the beginning of the week doing a talk to tell people about the secret, explain how it works, give us a little bit of a working knowledge on it. And again, that's perfect timing because after I saw it, I thought to myself, man, I'd love to get one of the principal people involved in this DVD on our show. And throw out the secret, and there I was. I got a chance to meet our guest, David Schirmer, and let's welcome him to the show this evening. Good evening, sir, and thank you very much for joining us here.
Hi, Dave. Hi, Tim. It's great to be on the show.
Well, we appreciate having you here, and I know it's probably a little step out of the boundaries from the normal radio shows you're doing that we're a paranormal radio show, talking about ghosts, UFOs, Bigfoot, but we always, you know, it always seems to come down to the same fundamental that we're all energy. We can exchange energy. We understand it. It's through travel. It's through time travel. It's through UFO activity and paranormal phenomena. And essentially, what you're kind of dealing with is tapping into something that is outside of normal consciousness, and it's learning how to get into that zone, almost like training yourself to be a psychic. Is that so far fetched a comparison?
Yeah, it's interesting because the majority of people think we're a physical being with an intellect and a spirit, and I'm sure you've discussed this many times on your show, that we're actually a spiritual being,
right,
with an intellect living in the physical body.
Okay.
When you start to come from that dimension, all of a sudden you realize that a lot of this, what people would say is nonsensical, is no sense, actually has sense, because there is no such thing as time and space in the spirit realm.
Mm-hmm. That's what's been so crazy to me is that that's, you know, as I sat there listening, I watched the DVD. I felt an impact just from watching the DVD, and I've watched it now about five or six times. I've been trying to really kind of get it in as you were teaching in the class. It's through repetition and understanding what you're doing, trying to build that muscle, if you will, and listening to some of the things you were talking about. And we'll get into that now. You have an interesting story. Let's start off at the beginning with that. You, yourself, you were a farmer in Australia. And kind of doing your own thing and in your own business. You didn't finish schooling, you said, correct? You kind of started. Why don't you give us a little bit of your background that way, and we'll kind of catch up to where we are today then.
Yeah, Dave, a pretty normal background, and I grew up as I spent over half my life on the land, left school, went back farming, and was living, I suppose you could call it a pretty normal farm life. Didn't have a high education, had no trade or university education. Actually invented a piece of machinery that for our own use and then went on to build that commercially. And so my interest in the whole business arena started there. And the interesting thing is I then didn't realize I was about to embark on the biggest lesson I'd have in life. I went in partnership with someone in business, and after 3 years of going from nothing to building a very successful company and product, my business partner decided they wanted the money more than I did, so they took it all.
Well, he was just implying the secret. Is that right there?
I'm not sure if it was the secret, but anyway, it certainly worked.
Right.
He got the law of attraction.
Well, that's right. He wanted it a lot more than you did, apparently.
Yeah, so I guess I didn't even understand any such thing as the secret. And the first book I read was probably Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. But I've got to say, I read that book four times and I couldn't get through it. I didn't really understand it. And over the next four or so years, things only got worse because not only did I no longer have a business and had a massive debt because of the business and lost everything that we had because of that, I was also now I didn't have a job and I had no education, no formal qualification. We didn't have any money. We couldn't pay all the bills and the debts, and we're constantly getting people wanting money, I was just totally overwhelmed, and some of your listeners can probably relate to this, where bills would come in the mail, and I wouldn't even open them because I knew what was inside of them, and I knew I couldn't pay it, and I was so overwhelmed I just put them in the bin. And things just went from bad to worse, and to a point where we had the phone cut off, the electricity turned off, we couldn't afford to feed our family even on welfare, and And so that's sort of the situation we're in. And so I started then searching for answers, I guess.
Right. And when you started doing this, and the thing I like about this, and I mean, it always seems it's these rags to riches stories, but it hits and it's so much more impactful than just, well, David Schirmer was born into the home of wealthy congressmen, you know, and you had the money spoon fed to you. You actually, this is something that you're able to show how it came into being. And the nice thing is with The Secret, we're not just going to cover money tonight. We're going to talk about how it can deal with relationships and jobs and things like that, because The Secret, I mean, it's so overwhelming what I'm learning just recently in reading the books after your class. I've ordered your set to start going over as well. In the meantime, waiting for that, I went out and I got the actual audiobook of The Secret so I could start listening to that. I bought the Secret Meditation CD to start listening to that at night as well. And, you know, I'm really trying to get into the swing of this, because some of the things that fascinated me most were some of the points that you brought up about how the law of attraction is basically what The Secret is. Correct?
Yeah, it is. And I guess the simplest way to explain this is you know, what you focus on, you get. Or, you know, the things that you desire in your heart, that's what you will become. So the law of attraction, it's not a question whether it exists or whether it works or doesn't. It's a bit like you know, the law of physics,
right.
the law of gravity in physics. It always works, and we don't know whether we understand it or not. It still works.
Exactly. If you jump off a building, you're going to hit the ground. That's just the way the law works.
Yeah, and the same with the law of attraction. Whether you understand how it works or what it is or not, the thing you preoccupy your mind with the most is the thing that you'll attract to you.
Right, and that's what I really like, because as I was listening, you know, the skeptical nature that we've all been born with, and the this sounds like a bunch of hippie mumbo jumbo, automatically starts to take place, and you start to, you know, yeah, we're all getting in touch with the global consciousness, and what we want will come to us. But the points that made were interesting to me were, you asked how many people here couldn't afford their first house, but they got it, and it worked for them. And I did. I jumped from an apartment to a house, and it happened. I wanted it, and it happened, and the money was there, and I never looked back. And I've upgraded 3 times since that time, always at the point where there's just really no way I could afford this, but I willed it into existence by tapping into The Secret without my knowing it, that was my focus. I never stood back and questioned. I never wavered. I never, you know, oh, God, this isn't going to work. I just knew that this is what I wanted. This is where I went. Same with our radio show, David, which I thought you might find interesting. It was, you know, about a year and 5 months ago, Tim and I sat down and we're just talking. And, you know, we met in college 20 years ago doing radio. We parted ways in the radio business. He continued on and I went into sales, but we've always had that camaraderie. And he said, you know, it just came up one day, hey Dave, would you like to do a radio show? What do you think we could do it on? I said, well, why don't we do the paranormal? It's different. It's hot right now. I know it. I love it. We've both had these experiences. And literally within a week's time, we launched a brand new radio show. We were picked up by a radio station, never having done the show before, never having any background in doing this type of show. But it was never a focus of mine of, oh, what if it doesn't work? Oh, what if nobody wants to do this? Tim said, can you get good guests? And within a week, within hours of the time we had the conversation, I had TV celebrities, authors, major names in the paranormal field that were booked with us. So, again, where I sit back and I think about all these points when things worked really well, it was me never focusing on, oh, I wish I could have a radio show. I wish I could have the, it was stepping up and doing, and it just happened and everything came together. That's pretty powerful to me. And that's why I wanted to do a show on this with the paranormal, because man, if that's not paranormal, I don't know what is. You're tapping into the above the normal. You're tapping into something that we're all capable of. And I'm sure if everybody stands back in their life and look at some of the things that have gone best in their life, they probably did it because they felt it, they did it, they didn't look back, they didn't worry, they didn't have concerns, they had a passion for what happened, and the universe had a way of rewarding us for it. I mean, do you find that with all the classes that you teach and the people you come across?
Yeah, and the more I've studied and learned about the mind and the universe, I guess one thing to say, to let people know, that I come to this information with a very staunch Christian background, where anything that's not either God or you can see in the physical realm is all hokey pokey and
right.
taboo. And then I find myself studying things that many people would consider that it's just totally out there, if you like. It's in the spirit realm, and you start to tell people that every single thing that is manifest in your life on the physical realm, you first created in the thought or the spiritual realm. You start saying that, and of course, many people's level of awareness has not evolved to that state, and they can't comprehend it. But the more I've studied it, you know, and I've been studying this now for, I guess, 16 years, the more amazed I am. And I started to study the law of vibration and the seven universal laws and how that the very picture you hold or the images you hold in your mind is you start to vibrate or you send vibration out from you that starts to attract everything on that level of vibration. And I can go through and show people example after example now of how what's happened to me and what's happened to other people. So, like you say, when you decide you want something, and you are so passionate about it that you have no doubt whatsoever, it's amazing it happens. And everyone's had this in their life in some capacity, whether it's a relationship, whether it's money. Whether it's a new job, whatever it is, or even in the negative, fear is one of the most destructive emotions that there are, but it's still an emotion, and the universe and the mind doesn't care whether it's good or bad for you. Whatever it is you focus on, that you'll get. And I was focusing on debt, and I was focusing on poverty and not being able to pay my bills, and I was focused on bills coming in the mail every day, and I manifested it perfectly.
Exactly. You brought the problems into your own world. We, you know, Tim and I saw that happen as well this year. We've started a paranormal retreat business. When we started doing this, there was really nobody else doing what we were doing in the field. And within months, you know, my fear was, you know, now everybody's going to jump on this bandwagon. And Tim and I started commiserating about it. And all of a sudden, there was 20 new groups joining up doing these paranormal retreats. And, you know, it's just kind of funny to sit back and think, you know, we sat there worried about it, and it sure as hell came on. And then as soon as we both stood up and said, but you know what, we offer the best retreats out there. We offer great people at our events. We're offering, you know, next to nothing for the price you're getting. You're getting all this phenomenal stuff, all of these great speakers, all of these wonderful places to go to that nobody else can offer. We have nothing to worry about. And slowly these people just started to dissipate, and the 20 grew to 4 and 4 down to 2, and now there's only one or two of them left out there. So it's been funny that as we've watched our own cyclical nature turn, you know, and change to reminding ourselves why we're doing what we do, the fears that we had, everything else just seems to fade away, like you were saying in the class, which that's really powerful to me because that is, you know, that's quantitative. Like when we're ghost hunting, you want to go out and see an apparition somewhere. You go out looking for UFOs. You want proof of it. This is something that if you put into effect, you know, it's one of those things that give it a try and it does happen for you, both sides.
Yeah. You know, I was, it's amazing, I was coming over on the plane on the way over to my trip in the U.S., this trip now, and I was sitting there just thinking about what's happened in my life, and I just started smiling when I realized something that was quite amazing. What happened 16 years ago when I was first told to write down a wish list. Many people have probably been to goal-setting workshops or read books where you write out a wish list and then you take out of that what you think is the most important. You set a goal and you write affirmations and so on. And, you know, people go through it and it doesn't work. But what was amazing, I was sitting thinking and I remember clearly the very second thing I wrote down on my wish list 16 years ago is that I wanted to be an international public speaker and change agent, changing millions of lives around the world.
Right.
Now, what was even more amazing to me, now I look back, when I wrote that down, I was so shy that I couldn't talk to two or three people. I had incredible shyness. I went through all my school years and I was shy. I wouldn't go and play sport because I would rather sit in the library by myself. And I actually went after I wrote that down, I look back now, I went along to a Toastmasters club that teaches you how to be confident speaking in public. And so here is an ex-farmer, uneducated, has no money, and can't speak in public, who writes down something that is so far opposite, it's hard to believe, that I wanted to be a public speaker, changing millions of lives around the world. Now, I never even had the education to do it. And here I am, sitting here, I'm in Chicago in the United States, on the opposite side of the world, and I've just finished a tour around the USA and speaking to hundreds of people. You know, I can't explain how the universe has organized that over 16 years. But it has brought everything together for that to be manifest. Now, if that's not proof of the law of attraction, I don't know what is.
I agree. And, you know, watching the DVD, for those of you that have seen the movie, our guest is David Schirmer. And David was the gentleman everybody recognizes as the parking space guy. You know, right? You said that people recognize you all the time as,
I'm the parking. I'm the car park guy.
Right. You think about getting that front row parking spot, and it's always there for you. And you said that even when it's not there for you, if you wait within 30 seconds, somebody pulls out and you pull in. I have to tell you what was really funny before I went to your class. I'm one of those guys, I'm always running last minute. And the class started in 15 minutes, and I'm 20 minutes across town, and I'm thinking, oh, crap, I'm never going to make it. And I said, nope, stop that. Just drive, get there, it's all going to be fine. Because I just watched A Secret. I was trying to imply what I learned in there or apply it and started driving and didn't hit the traffic like I always do when I'm all worked up and worried and angry and frustrated. I made it there. Not only did I make it there, when I pulled into the front lot, it was completely packed. And normally what would stress me out of, oh, crap, now I got to look. I just drove around the back, and bam, right there by one of the main doors, wide open parking spot. So I parked in there, walked in. I showed up 2 minutes before you began the event, and I was plenty in time. I mean, that, to me, that sounds silly. But again, when you can start to put these little things into effect, like testing it on trying to get a parking spot, think about it. I'm not going to be stressed that I'm going to get there and not find a place to park. You know, it's going to be there. And it is. It's been there. I've been testing that all week. Wherever I go, I'm like, oh, man, this is going to be great, another front-row parking spot. And as I drive into the parking lot, there's a front-row spot for me and 100 cars packed everywhere else, but there's one spot open, perfect size for my vehicle and everything. So it is funny, but, I mean, that's a good way to start the muscle building, wouldn't you agree? Just start doing the small stuff like that and see if it comes through for you, how it works and how to focus on doing that.
Yeah, you know, faith and belief come through knowledge and understanding, but when we haven't got any cells of recognition or any past experience of it working, we have to get some experience. And you know, you've seen it work now with a parking space, which will now give you more confidence to do something bigger and better with it. And so, you know, I see a lot of negative reports about The Secret. In fact, I just logged onto the internet tonight, and there was a whole list of negative comments that have been placed on the net about this crazy thing called The Secret and why it won't work. But the interesting thing is the people who make the comments never try it. And even if you try it with something small, an example that Rhonda Byrne says that of a young guy that decided to test to see if it works. He decided that he would manifest a feather. Not any feather. It had to be a certain feather with an exact coloring and marking. It was quite unique. And I believe it was in New York. Now, for that feather to be there, it was uncommon for even that type of bird to be there. Well, he just focused on that every day and totally believed it would happen. And lo and behold, he was walking along the street and there it was. Now, you say, well, that's something silly and something small. But when you consider that the whole universe has got to conspire to your thoughts to make this happen, you start to get some sort of comprehension of how we as co-creators act and react with the creator or the universe. And I was sharing with someone today that every single thought we have, the moment we have the thought, it transmits throughout the entire universe in an instant, And molecules are starting to be changed in line with that thought.
Interesting. Well, you know, we have to take a quick break here in a second. Let me ask you a quick question that maybe you can mull over for us, and then we'll get more into the secret. But as a paranormal question, one of the things that we've often done is you ask for signs, you know, and people, you know, my father passed away 10 years ago, but he always smoked Pall Mall cigarettes. And, you know, Dad, if you're out there, show me a sign. And you go somewhere and there's a pack of Pall Mall cigarettes and nobody smokes them anymore. Why the hell are they sitting there? Do you feel that that is also using the law of attraction to get the signs from the universe that you're looking for the comfort and the love?
My answer is yes, and if you're going to go for a break, I can answer more afterwards.
Great. We'll do that when we come back. You're listening to the Darkness on the Edge of Town Paranormal Radio Show. I'm your host, Dave Schrader. Our guest is David Schirmer, and tonight we're learning about The Secret.
Once you have seen Dave and Tim in the light, you'll understand why we must return to the darkness on the edge of town. Stay tuned. There is more to come.
For 58 years, Fate has consistently supplied its loyal readership with a broad array of true reports of the strange and unknown. Fate is a factual magazine containing articles by experts in all walks of life, and by others just like you who have something dynamic, significant, and truthful to say. Keep up with the latest on angels and miracles, psychic phenomena, ghosts, UFOs, archaeological hotspots, alternative science, and much, much more. To receive your free Fate magazine, call now at 1-800-728-2730 or visit our website at www.fatemag.com. That's 1-800-728-2730 or www.fatemag.com. What are you waiting for? Your fate awaits.
Are you tired of reading about what couple in Hollywood is breaking up or divorcing? Have you ever wondered where you can find the news that covers the subjects that you are really interested in? I would like to invite you to visit SupernaturalNews.com. Supernatural News uses the latest internet technology to search for the topics we know you will be interested in reading. News of the latest Bigfoot, UFO, or Loch Ness Monster sightings. Read about the latest conspiracy theories and urban legends. Supernatural News, where belief and reality merge.
Ghosts, goblins, witches, creatures of the night. Yep, that just about covers everybody Dave and Tim have ever dated.
Oh my God, this girl's really turning me on.
Welcome back to the darkness on the edge of town.
Good evening and welcome back to the show. This is Dave Schrader. Along with us this evening, our guest is David Schirmer. And for those of you that may not be familiar with this yet, there's a great book and a DVD out there called The Secret. And it's talking about tapping into the laws of attraction and the power of the universe out there to get the things in your life that you want. Love, money, jobs, anything that you want to desire, it'll show you how to get there. Or at least it starts to give you the building blocks. And we'll get into some more of that in a few minutes. But before I went to break, I'd asked Mr. Schirmer about the paranormal aspect of this. You know, so many people want a sign from a loved one that, you know, smell grandma's wild hyacinth perfume or see a pack of Pall Mall cigarettes somewhere, you know, something that's obscure and it shows itself. And before I went to break, you said you do believe that it does have an effect as well, but you wanted to expound upon that. So I'll shut up and turn the field over to you.
Yeah, Dave, I guess there's a lot of things that people can't explain. The thing that I do know is everything on the intellectual and physical realm is dominated by the spiritual realm. Now, that means that thought, which is on the spiritual realm, which is energy in the most powerful, in its most powerful state, which means its highest frequency and amplitude of vibration, affects everything on both the intellectual and physical plane. And as I say to people, everything on the physical plane can be changed, altered, or made better through the thought or the spiritual realm. Now, if a person is focusing on receiving a sign, and they focus on that, what they're actually doing is they're not focusing on the physical plane. They're using their intellect to then focus on the spiritual plane or the plane of thought. Now, as the more we understand this process, what we're literally doing is we're putting a vibration out to the universe to say, attract this to me. Now, we do that, And we can explain it probably a dozen different ways. But ultimately, if we focus with such intensity and emotion, and one thing that is good, helpful to understand, is the subconscious mind is the emotional mind. It's pure emotion. The only way we can affect it or change it is by massive emotion. Now, when someone's focusing on a sign, it's normally high intensity of emotion, which means that then is instantly sending that thought vibration, if you like, out to the universe and starts to attract to you that very thing. And so, absolutely, it's not only believable, but it's actually real that we can and do create things that may seem unexplainable in the physical realm, such as signs, through the power of thought.
I firmly believe that. You know, one other thing that I'd like to ask you in the paranormal realm of this, before we get into more of the fundamentals of the secret, so many believers in ufology believe that they're making contact, and I don't know if you have a faith or belief in any of this type of thing, but so many of them claim that they can call them down simply with their thoughts and by putting out the intent that they want to see physical manifestations, they want to see UFOs or creatures or things like that. And, you know, so many people will be at one place doing that and they all see it and experience the same thing. There's a very famous gentleman out there that goes by the name Prophet Yahweh, who I believe is in Nevada. He claims he can call down UFOs at any given time, and they followed him around. A news crew actually said, "We're going to take you somewhere." And they took him out to a field where they didn't tell him where they were going, so he couldn't pre-set something up. And he stood there and just began to pray and call down to these things. And sure enough, out of the sky comes this silver ball, and the film crew is watching it, and the cameraman's watching it, and the news guy's watching it, and they're all kind of blown away by this. But he was, in effect, he's doing what The Secret is all about. He was calling out to the universe, calling out for physical proof that these things were there and that they should show themselves, and these came forward. I mean, what are your thoughts or beliefs on something like that?
You know, whether people believe in the Bible or Christianity or not, it says there that we are made in the likeness and image of God. And Jesus said, "All the things I have done, you too can do and more." Now, he walked on water. He healed the sick. He made the dead alive. Now, when we think about that, and then we relate to what you just said, then it makes that very possible. It makes it not only very possible, but it actually makes sense that you take that our creation, whether you believe it's God or some other greater force or energy, that the universe was created at some point in time. Now, if the universe was created by the being or the thing or the God that created us, and we are given the same, if you like, co-creative ability with that power, then why can't we do that? Like, God created the universe, or energy or the power created the universe, and if we have the same if we are co-creators with that power, then once we evolve to a level of awareness, is it not possible that we could actually create a universe?
Well, definitely, and that's what's so fascinating to me about this, is it's just bringing all these things together by your will. I hate to give it like the God complex sense, but in a sense it is. It's because even the Bible, God says, if you ask for it, I'll give it to you. It's yours. You're meant to live in abundance.
Yeah, and that's the thing that most people that are Christians don't get. It says, ask and you will receive.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it doesn't say ask and you receive, but don't ask for money. It doesn't say ask,
right,
receive, and don't ask for a happy, fulfilled relationship or love. It doesn't say ask and you will receive, but don't ask me for health. It says ask and you will receive. We put the conditions on what we receive. What it's telling us is we can ask for whatever and we will receive it.
Right, and that's the main thing, is you have to want and you have to call out. There is no... We as humans have put a ceiling on it, right? well, we shouldn't ask for this. It's not polite to ask the universe to make me a millionaire. It's not polite to, because that's too greedy. I shouldn't do that. I just need enough to get by. And that's kind of what limits us, right? It's the fear. It's the self-limitations that we impose on ourselves, as opposed to letting the universe and God or whatever enlightened being that you believe in deliver the things that they've promised would be delivered to you.
Absolutely. See, the whole concept of, well, I can't ask for $1 million because that's greedy. Now, is greed an aspect of total abundance of which the universe is, or is it an aspect of the lack of abundance? And so even the concept of greed is not something that's provided to us by the infinite universe, because the universe is infinite. It's all abundant. Everywhere we look through the universe, we look into the sky, we look into the heavens, we see, you know, there's just an infinite abundance. And we look around us, we even get a microscope, and we look into the smallest particle we can look at below the atom and the neutron and the proton, and we see these huge spaces that are filled with energy. And then so everywhere we look, there's this incredible abundance. Wallace D. Wattles, in his book, The Science of Getting Rich, said something that just blew me away. He called it the formless substance. And he said the entire universe was made from the formless substance. And he said, and there is so much, and it is everywhere, in all places, at all times. He said there is so much formless substance that many, many more universes could be created and it still would not be depleted. And so there's this abundance in the universe, and yet we have poverty, we feel greedy. You know, that doesn't make sense. That greed is something, or poverty is something that's created in a person's mind, or in a man or a woman's mind. It's not created from the universe. The universe wants us to enjoy that abundance. We actually create the lack of it.
I firmly believe that. And if pop culture taught us anything, right, Tim? Gordon Gekko, as played by Michael Douglas, taught us greed is good.
Greed works.
Greed works. That's the way it goes. So you got to call it in and want it. Yeah, I think, how do people, I mean, with The Secret, people want to tap into it. For years, I did all the self-help books. I did the Brian Tracy books and the Anthony Hopkins and
Tom Hopkins.
Yeah, Tom Hopkins. I'm sorry, Anthony. Suddenly I've got Hannibal Lecter telling me how to live my life. But you've got Tom Hopkins. You've got Anthony Robbins. Yeah, that's right. Anthony Robbins, right?
Isn't he?
Yeah, he's a good. Okay, that's what I'm talking about. All these guys, and they teach you, you got to set up a goal and you got to write down the goal and that's it. Now, you know, Stewie from our chat room here who's listening in said, he's written goals down, I want this, but it doesn't work. So he said that's kind of been the problem that he's always had. But there's a fundamental problem, which is writing down I want. Is that correct? I mean, is there a better way for people to start instilling The Secret and how they can actually make it work for them?
Absolutely. There's a number of problems there, and again, it's because of the lack of knowledge or ignorance that we do that. And many of the courses and the programs you mentioned, I went through and have done as well. And I got to the point I was totally frustrated with the whole self-help movement, because I thought I was doing everything that they said, and I would write the goals down, and I'd write the affirmations, I'd read them over and over and over again every day. And 4 years later, I was still broke.
Exactly.
And so I was quite disillusioned. But there was a certain turning point in my life, which I can come back to later if you like. But to answer your question, the words I want is putting it out into the future. If you're wanting something, then it means you haven't got it, and you'll always be chasing it. And so there's a couple of key components in manifestation or the law of attraction. One of them is that you have to state I am or I have. I suggest people start off their statement or their affirmation by I am so happy and grateful now that I. And that evokes a number of the laws of the universe. One is in present tense. Another one is gratitude.
Mm-hmm.
And so you are putting yourself in the realm of already having. Now, whether someone understands that or not, that is excessively powerful, because what's happened now, see, the conscious mind has a concept of time, and it knows past, present, or future, but the subconscious mind in the universe doesn't. There's no concept of time or quantity, and so everything is just in the now. And so there's no concept of past or future. So when what you're really doing is you're tricking the subconscious mind, so it doesn't know the difference between what's real or what's imagined, because it doesn't have any concept of time. And so you can imagine as if you already have it, and that's the important key. You've got to focus on, or your affirmation's got to be that you already do have it. I have and enjoy these things. And again, I take people back, and I haven't read all the different religious texts, but I'm led to believe that many of them are the same. But I do understand the Bible says that Jesus said, when you pray, and pray is just a form of meditation or visualization, and when you pray, pray believing that you already have it, and it will be yours.
Hmm.
Now, many people have read that and still don't understand it. But what that means is when you visualize as if it's now, be grateful or give thanks that you are enjoying it now as if you already have it, and it will be yours. And this goes back to as a man thinketh, what Solomon said, as a man thinketh in his heart, so will he become.
Right.
Yeah.
That's...
And so you literally, you've got to focus, and not only do you create it that you already have it in your mind, because you can create nothing on the physical plane until first you create it in the thought or the spiritual realm, so you create it in the spiritual realm, and you attach emotion to it, and that's really important. You must think as if you already have it now, and live those emotions.
Makes a lot of sense. We're going to take another quick break here, and then we'll come back and finish up with some more, and then we'll be coming after the top of the hour back with David Schirmer. He's going to be spending all 2 hours with us. We appreciate his time. Thank you very much for tuning in. I hope you're getting something out of this. And again, if you have any questions, you can email them in to tim@darknessradio.com, or you can go into our live chat room where you can pop in and ask questions there, and we'll try to get them answered on the air as well. Thank you very much for tuning in to the Darkness on the Edge of Town Paranormal Radio Show with our guest David Schirmer talking about The Secret.
We thought El Chupacabra meant the cup of coffee in Spanish.
Mi amo Eduardo Especial. ¿Cómo está el yay?
What you talking about, Willis?
Shows you what we know. Stay tuned. There's more to come from the darkness on the edge of town.
For 58 years, Fate has consistently supplied its loyal readership with a broad array of true reports of the strange and unknown. Fate is a factual magazine containing articles by experts in all walks of life, and by others just like you who have something dynamic, significant, and truthful to say. Keep up with the latest on angels and miracles, psychic phenomena, ghosts, UFOs, archaeological hotspots, alternative science, and much, much more. To receive your free Fate magazine, call now at 1-800-728-2730 or visit our website at www.fatemag.com. That's 1-800-728-2730. Or www.fatemag.com. What are you waiting for? Your fate awaits.
George Clooney, Carmen Diaz, Oprah, Ellen, George Bush, Diane Pelosi.
What are you doing?
I'm making a list of people I want to tell about charity checks.
Do you know any of those people?
No, but if I can get to them, they might want to tell the public how cool it is to use giving certificates as presents instead of gift certificates.
Giving certificates?
Yeah, you know. They can be used as a donation to any legitimate charity. So the person who gives a charity check gets the tax deduction, and the person who gets one decides where the money goes.
Why don't you just tell people directly about charity checks yourself?
Like anyone would listen to me. www.charitychecks.us for information about the perfect present.
Well, no, they're not going to listen to you like that. But if you just said that charity checks provides a unique way to turn your gift money into giving money, they might pay attention.
Catchy.
Then you just casually say the web address, charitychecks.us, America's Giving Certificate.
I still think a celebrity endorsement would be more effective.
If you read Taxpayer Mag every month, you'll be able to tell the difference between the absurd.
Could not go to work because Bigfoot stole my car.
And the creepy. Taps Paramag takes you where few would ever go on purpose. From exclusive interviews with the cast of The Ghost Hunters to the latest trends in technology in the field of the paranormal. To join our journey, order at tapsparamag.com.
Are you tired of reading about what couple in Hollywood is breaking up or divorcing? Have you ever wondered where you can find the news that covers the subjects that you are really interested in? I would like to invite you to visit supernaturalnews.com. Supernatural News uses the latest internet technology to search for the topics we know you will be interested in reading. News of the latest Bigfoot, UFO, or Loch Ness monster sightings. Read about the latest conspiracy theories and urban legends. Supernatural News, where belief and reality merge.
Two ghosts walk into a bar and see another ghost at the bar point at them and yell, "Boo!" One of the ghosts yells back, "Boo-hoo!" And the ghost at the bar yells back, "Well, you don't have to cry about it." Ah, hell, you try writing this.
You magnificent bastard! I salute you!
Welcome back to the darkness on the edge of town.
Good evening and welcome back to the darkness. Hopefully we're taking you back into the light with us this evening as we talk to our guest David Schirmer about The Secret. Our guest is one of the main principals on the DVD of The Secret, also helped with the book. You'll see quotes and information from him in there. The Secret is very fascinating. It's learning how to tap into the law of attraction, using the law of attraction. And the law of attraction basically is, whatever you think of, whatever you want, becomes, correct? I mean, isn't that what you're doing with the law of attraction? Like attracts like. And if you're positive and you're focused on what you want and you're not letting the bad vibes in, you get what you want when you focus on it.
One of the easiest ways to explain to people the law of attraction, Dave, is when someone, if you walk into a room and someone is depressed, you can feel it before they even say anything.
Right.
And what you'll notice is when people are depressed or in that energy space, what sort of people do they attract into their life? They attract people who are moaning, groaning, and typically that type of person.
Misery loves company, sure.
Yeah, and so it's interesting. We can also go into a room or a party or a bar, and we can meet someone we've never known in our life, and we can sit down and talk to them for 2 or 3 or 5 minutes, and then we just feel like we've known them for years, and we use the terminology. We say, I feel like you're on my wavelength or on the same wavelength. Well, what we're doing is we're literally explaining the law of attraction, because we've attracted that person is on the same level of vibration as we are, and that's why we're together. We've literally attracted each other.
No, I firmly believe that, because you do. You walk into a place, and the guy that's laughing and fun, you see everybody around him, they're always having a good time, and you get the sad sack over in the corner, and people that go over there try to get him up and happy, they all end up kind of dejected and commiserating about how crappy their life is, and, well, you think that's bad, you should hear what happened to me, and it just turns into the spiraling thing, and you just keep, it's magnetic, right? I mean, you just keep drawing more of that crap to you when you do that.
Yeah, to have a pity party.
How do we break? See, that's where my fear comes in, and the DVD and the book are scratching on it for me. But that's where I'm having trouble is because I've always been kind of one of those waiting for the other shoe to drop guy. I'm trying to get out of that frame of thought. I'm trying to not focus on the negative that could happen. I'm trying to just stay focused on this is what I want, this is what I see, this is where I want to be. But in the back of my mind, David, I've got the voice going, yeah, right. This ain't going to happen, schmuck. You know this thing's going to fall apart. It always does. How do we turn that voice off?
Well, you don't really turn it off until you replace the thing that's causing the voice. And to help people understand this a little better, and I shared at the event where you come along, Dave, and I showed people a little example about the conscious and
right.
The subconscious mind. The mind is the activity or the process from the idea or a concept through to a physical result, and the mind is in two components, conscious and subconscious. Now, the subconscious of us, part of us doesn't think; it's the part that stores the habits or the images that we make choices by habit, and so most of the images that are programmed in the subconscious mind we never actually chose. And so as we're little children, our parents, our teachers, our siblings, our environment, our circumstances created images, because we couldn't reason when a baby is born. They don't reason whether, you know, should they be in that family or another family, or what's hot, what's cold. They can't reason, and so their faculty of reasoning is not yet developed, and it's not fully developed until the age of 9 to 12 years old. And so all the information that a child is surrounded by and hears and sees and touches and so on, those images go straight into the child's subconscious mind. Now, they say that over 95% of all the decisions we make on a day-by-day basis are made subconsciously. Now, what that means is the decisions are made based on the images that's already programmed in our subconscious mind. Now, when you start to think something new, and a person may be like I was, just totally broke, And I went through an exercise and worked out how much I wanted to live. You know, I was earning less than $5,000 a year. And I went through an exercise, I went through and created a budget of how I'd like to live, to set some goals, and it came out at $43,600 a month.
Now, hey, I'd like to live like that too, David.
For most people, that would sound like a joke.
Right.
And certainly it did for me. And my conscious mind is screaming, you're an idiot. How could you do that? You're broke. You have no money. Where are you going to get that sort of money? Who's going to give that to you? That's a bunch of lies. And so your conscious mind is digging up the past based on the images in your subconscious mind and telling you you're stupid. Now, this is interesting because we do know you can't reject those thoughts, or you can't reject at least the images in your subconscious mind, but we do know you can replace them. But it takes time, and it takes constant effort, and this is where the willpower comes into it. So if you take a new image, and I took an image, instead of thinking of bills and poverty and being broke all the time, I took an image of abundance. I took an image of what my life would feel like if I was earning $43,600 per month. So I took that image and I started to focus on that with emotion as if I was living it now. Now, I can tell you right away, it's a very different state or energy of going out and collecting a mail knowing you've got more bills that you can't pay.
Right.
Or living $43,600 a month. It's a different feeling totally. Now, you can. It doesn't matter what a person's state is. They can close their eyes and they can think that, and they can start to enter into that emotion. Now, you start to do that, and you do it the first day, and the second day, and the third day, and your negative thoughts are coming up constantly, saying you're an idiot. You can't do that. There's no way you can do that. But what's amazing, if you keep doing that for 12 to 15 days, you will notice. Every time you get a negative thought, you go back to focusing on what it is you want. Somewhere between day 12 to 15, all of a sudden you start half believing it's possible.
So that's almost like the old turbo fake it till you make it, right?
Absolutely. That's where it came from.
Okay.
And so you're faking it till you're making it, but what you're doing is you're actually replacing the images in your subconscious mind that cause you to be broke. You attracted that situation. So you attracted, or I attracted being broke. I attracted that circumstance into my life that created that. I wasn't aware that I did, and most people are not aware of how or what they attract in their life, but the truth is, everyone makes the choices that leads them to that point. And so I'd made certain choices that led me to that point. Now,
so that's important to bring up, too. Taking ownership of why you are where you are. It's really easy for me to sit here and bitch and complain that I'm here because my ex-wife did this to me, or my boss is a jerk, or the people at work are keeping me from getting where I want to be, right? I mean, you, first of all, most importantly, once you take ownership that, hey, I made the decisions to marry this person, I made the decisions to be a part or not be a part of this marriage, I made the decisions to not work as hard as I should, or to spend more time schmoozing than I did working, you take ownership of that and realize it instead of putting the blame somewhere else. Then you can start to actually work and build on it. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely. Until we accept that we are in the position where we're in because we've chosen to be, then we will probably never move forward. And I guess that was one of the hardest lessons for me because I was, you know, we had no money, and I went and shared our situation with the only person I ever shared it totally with, because we needed some money to buy some food for our children. And I said, Keith, can we borrow $100? And he put his hand in his pocket, and he pulled out $100, and he handed it to me. And then he said these words. He said, you're in the place where you are because you've chosen to be there. Well, I got angry. I wanted to punch him in the nose.
Right.
But I needed the $100 more, so I never. But I went away and thought about that. And see, it doesn't matter whether a person is overweight, if they're in a job they don't like, if they've just been in a marriage they don't like, if they've got no money. Every one of those is that person has made choices for them to be there. They made the choice to get married. They made the choices to enter that relationship. They made the choices to eat that food. They made the choices to stay in that employment. Whatever it is, each individual has made the choices to be there. Whether they like the choice or not doesn't matter. The thing is to accept that, okay, I'm here now, and I don't like it, but I now have the power to change it. And once a person gets to that point, it's incredibly freeing. A person realizes that we have the power.
No, I totally agree, and that's going to be a good break point as we're going to run into the top of the hour here, and then we're going to take a quick break. So if you could just stick with us here in the darkness on the edge of town, our guest is David Schirmer. We're going to be back for another hour. Now that we know what we're dealing with and we know where the problem lies, we're going to work on getting you and the listeners out here and anybody that would like to chime in with questions, we're going to help get you in gear and at least get you on the right path. And by the end of the show, I'm going to give you some links and information on how you can hook up with Mr. Schirmer for more information and some of the different books and tapes that he offers as well. Thank you for joining us here. Make sure that you stick with us. Hour 2 is coming up right after this.